Hey, come in here, want y'all to see something. 1, 2, 3, with icing and everything in between. A 3-layer chocolate cake cooked in a Dutch oven. And folks, we call this a Mexican chocolate cake. But you're gonna have to stick around to find out why this is the most unique, most flavorful chocolate cake you've ever tasted in your life. I've seen cowboys come in on ranches and be looking around, searching, wondering what old Cookie did for dessert. But folks, we going above and beyond today. A triple decker Mexican chocolate cake with a buttercream icing on there. Oh my gosh, it is going to be delicious. And we're going to cook it all right here in camp in 3 Dutch ovens. Well, ain't no sense in beating around the bush here. We need to go ahead and get started, because if you'll look at Major, he's looking a little thin and wanting some chocolate cake. We started off with 3 cups all-purpose flour, 3 cups white sugar. Next, we're gonna add 1.5 cups of unsweetened cocoa, 4 teaspoons of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of salt. Now, there's a secret to this Mexican chocolate cake, and you be telling yourself, I know what it is. I know, it's Mexican vanilla. Well, it could be, but there's also something else that you didn't figure on. What is that? Dried ancho chili powder. Yes. Now, you be thinking, oh, it's going to be spicy. No. When you got an ancho chili, remember in them earlier videos when I talked about my favorite chilies, and ancho was one of them, it gives a chocolatey flavor, but also a little smokiness to it. So it goes well in chocolate cake, and we are going to put 3 teaspoons in there. Yes, we are. Well, the dry is all mixed together. Let's set that one aside. Let me reach down here in my pantry and get a bowl for the wet. The 1.5 cups of buttermilk is in there. It is, and that, I think that is also another secret to chocolate cake, because every chocolate cake that I ever made in my life always had buttermilk in it first, and that's gonna just give it so much flavor. Now, it is optional in this recipe, and sure optional today, because it said you can use some coffee that you have brewed up, or you can use water. The coffee pot turned over too, so we have no coffee, so today we're gonna add water. So if you're adding the coffee to it, it's gonna also, when you think about coffee, say you've just got a regular coffee bean, and you put that in your mouth and you bite it, you're gonna get a little bit of the coffee taste, but you're gonna also get that little hint of chocolate to it, because really this has got chocolate in everything that's going along with it. Some melted butter, and be sure you sort of pour that in there slowly, give it a stir, or make sure it's cool enough that it ain't gonna curdle that buttermilk anymore. 4 large cackleberry. Well, Mage, we got them cackleberries. What are you doing down there? We got them cackleberries all mixed up in there really well, we do. Now it's time to add some vanilla. But remember, this is a Mexican chocolate cake, so we're gonna use Mexican vanilla. Now,
what is the difference?
To me, there's such a richer taste to it. It's got that taste of more like fresh vanilla. Have you ever had fresh where they got the vanilla bean, you know, and they scrape that vanilla out of there? To me, this is about as close as it gets to that. You could use regular, and I don't know what you'd do to substitute with it to make it taste more like this, but if you do have it, go ahead. But if you got this, it's what I prefer. There's 1, and there's 2. Now, when it comes time to mix the wet with the dry, I just don't want you just to pour it all in there. I just want you to pour and mix slowly till we get everything incorporated. I'm gonna make me a little well right in there so it'll stay right there. Go to mixing. You can see the wind is blowing, Shen, it is.
You want me to hold this for you?
Uh-huh, it's trying to run away, it is.
Is that what you call high speed?
Uh-huh, that's high left-handed. And I want Shen to look over here. Culinary is hard at work over here. Good job, Magey. You need to get 3 9-inch cake pans. You need to grease them really well, and then I like to flour too. But we're gonna show you how we do a Dutch oven. Do it all this time, even when we're on a ranch. Take you any kind of lubrication here besides WD-40. Give it a really good coating. Then I want you to sprinkle a little flour in there. Now, I'm gonna go even further than that, because this is what all the good bakers do that be telling me they know how to bake. They use cocoa powder.
Really?
Yes. Now, sprinkle you some in there. Then you need to be doing this deal here to where you shake it around. Try to get it all the way around the sides if you can. Give it a little knock on the cabinet if you got one, and you can see that is what we call coated. Be sure you shake the excess out. My kitchen is a little unlevel, and folks, we're gonna divide this evenly, I hope, into thirds.
Do you ever leave any in the bowl to lick?
Occasionally, I do.
How do you feel about your precision on your evenly?
Well, I'm gonna tell you right now, kitchen is sloping a little, but I think we're pretty close, we are. Ain't no sense in baking it. We just pour that over a biscuit and eat it. But there is one other trick you need to know, and it's sort of hard to do on this table, and I want you to see these bubbles, all that's in this cake. We need to get some of them air bubbles out. And how do you do that? You can just give it a little shaking. Well, we got them ready to go now if we just had them cooked. If somebody can go ahead and take these to the house and put them in a oven, Shan, it'd help me out, okay?
It would. Especially today because it got windy.
It did get windy. But folks, if you'll meet me over at the fire, I got a little something I want to show you. But remember all this dried grass? Well, we're going to make sure today that we set up above that. And if you watch the baked chicken video, you'll see what happened to that contraption I had built. But I broke out my old reliable here, so I'll meet you over to the stove and we'll get to cooking. We have been in a drought so long, when Noah come by, we didn't get but a half inch, so he couldn't come by up this far. But they had a lot of dry fodder all the way around here. So you see me break out this big old table that we got here. It's about 10 inches off the ground. Keeps them coals off the ground. You know, when I cook a cake, it's always on a tall trivet. And they're about 5 inches is what they are. And you always start out with pretty light coals around the outside edge and pretty light coals on top, because we got to cook this slow. Y'all seen, there's a lot of moisture in this cake, so we got to let it cook slowly, rise up to its maximum capacity. I'm using some Fogo hardwood lump charcoal today. Let it get good and white hot. That's what we're after. It doesn't take much. We use really light coals around the outside edge of the Dutch oven and pretty light on top. Try to get them spaced out there to where you ain't got one oven touching another, and if you're cooking them all at the same time. Now, the wind is blowing out of the north, so we're gonna have to rotate pretty frequently the bottom one way, the top the other way, and we may have to pull some coals away, take some off the lid, but we gotta keep it as slow as we can. But also, I've cooked in a lot of wash tubs, I've cooked in a lot of wheelbarrows, cooked on the inside of trash cans. Whatever you gotta do to keep this to where we're not burning something up, you can get it done. Well, we've been on about maybe 10 minutes at the most, and folks, I'm thinking we're a little hot, so I'm gonna shake some of them off, but let's take a look. You can see that cake is cooking right along, so we're gonna pull these coals back from the side also. So let me get me, because we need to slow this down. We'll pull them coals back some. But you got to remember too, when you're cooking on something that's a metal surface, you're increasing the heat value too, so remember that. I have a cake stick. A lot of people are going to use a toothpick, but I'm going to use a cottonwood branch. It gives your cake better flavor. That's what you call Olympic record time right there. I've had some cakes cook really fast in my lifetime, but never 12 minutes. I mean, it's like microwave cake today. Sure, cooking on the table is going to give you extra heat and radiant heat, and the wind blowing about 15 to 20 is going to make it even hotter than that. So folks, we're really fortunate on this one. It is just right. It's already done. The reason we took them off the bottom heat over here is because they're cooking way too fast. They are, due to all that radiant heat. And we took all the coals off the lid, but just two little spots on two separate ovens. And when you can take that lid off and you look down there and you see that separation around the outside edge of that to where that cake is beginning to pool, you're getting pretty close on the bottom and the outside edges. You pull a cake out of the oven because you think it's near done, but you see that spot sort of right there in the middle that's still got a little wiggle in it, sort of looks like Jell-O a little bit. Well, folks, that happens to me a lot cooking in a Dutch oven, and that's when we have to really target heat or spot heat. We'll take like one coal and put directly under the center of that Dutch oven and pile us two little coals up there around the bale on that to where it is centered on that lid. That way we can target the heat top and bottom to try to cook that slow enough to where that's getting some extra heat, but the rest of it ain't really cooking. Minute cake and 4 minutes to ice it. That's what you call record breaking time right there. Now that icing really is just a butter and softened cream cheese, cinnamon, powdered sugar, Mexican vanilla, but also some of that ancho chili powder in it as well. It's going to give it that great taste.
I was impressed with your icing skills, honestly.
I mean, look, I put the whip stip cup of, I mean, it like all over it I did. That comes from them years of troweling concrete, it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this piece off right here because that's the one I want. Smooth like chocolate. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory ain't got nothing on me, folks. The ancho chili, you can feel it gets in there. It makes it really rich and chocolatey, but that Mexican vanilla sort of puts it over the top. The two combined, you can't go wrong with.
You know, honestly though, it's not what I thought it would taste like. I thought it would be kind of spicy, have a kick, but it's just it just gives it almost like a richer,
it's
something different chocolate.
It's really rich, like rich dark chocolate at first that you get, and then you get that sweetness that it brings out. But also I can taste a little bit of that smokiness in there, but that Mexican vanilla sort of smooths it all out, and it is good as gold. But it is with always and great pleasure and pride and honor that I tip my hat to all our servicemen and women and all the veterans who have kept that old flag flying over camp. It is. To the rest of you, come on in here. Get really close because this is going to be dangerous.
Are you going to lift it?
I'm going to lift this here cake up right here. Mm-hmm. I want y'all to look at the layers in there, the goodness. God bless you each and every one, and I'll see you down the Mexican chocolate cake trail.